Well, stimulated by Horti, I guess you're all set to witness the presentation on application of 22 Shruti Harmonium in accompaniment. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to the artists on dais, Dr. Vidyadhar Oak, Dr. Srikantham Nagendra Shastri ji, Shri Rajendra Vaishampayana ji. We already have a great good familiarity with Dr. Vidyadhar Oak ji and Shri Rajendra Vaishampayana ji because we have already seen them on the same platform in the same summit of 2020. We have witnessed a presentation on the 22 Shruti making and the first, third and fifth note explanation yesterday in a video presentation given by Vidyadhar sir, where he explained if sa is to be 100 hertz or frequency, whatever we call it, and the higher sa to be the next frequency, how the difference between first, third and fifth note takes a systematic difference where it forms the first, third and fifth note, which forms the Western chord system as well. So once again, warm welcome to you, sir. We already have great familiarity with you. But ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause at another time to Dr. Vidyadhar Oak ji. With him, we have Shri Rajendra Vaishampayana ji, who is also familiar from the same platform. We have already introduced him. So round of applause to welcome him as well. Hosadagi ee summit nalli nammana serpade agirontadu antane Dr. Srikantham Nagendra Shastri avaru. Parampare plays a vital role in development or existence of any art form. Chintalapalli Parampare, Karnataka Shastriya Sangeeta, the ulivu mattu belavanigege dodda mattada ondu kaanikeyanna neediruvantadu. Aa ondu paramparege seriruvanta ee ondu naadina hemmeya vidvamsaru Srikantham Nagendra Shastri avaru. He already has started Chintalapalli Parampara Trust, from which he is promoting young upcoming artists as well as paying respect to the great senior artists. So eradu ondu peeligeyanna sambhalista eradu peeligege samanavadanta mahatvana kodta ondu visheshavadanta trust na kuda nadastha idare. Igagle aneka vedikegalalli ivaru pratyakshikegalannu needidare, goshti gayanavanna saha aneka vedikegalalli yashasviyagi nerverisi kottiruvantaru. Ladies and gentlemen, request you all to kindly join me in welcoming Vidwan Shri Srikantham Nagendra Shastri ji also for the presentation. This is demonstration or presentation on application of 22 Shruti harmonium in accompaniment.
Thank you so much for joining us in this session. I remember a story where there is an elephant and somebody touched their feet, somebody the trunk, somebody the tail and all that. But most of the time, everybody described the elephant in the perspective of what they experienced out of that elephant. And so the perspective that the person had about the elephant was not exactly correct in its entirety. So today, we are going to try and get the idea about the entirety of the concept called a Shruti. And in a way, we are going to demystify this elephant in such a fashion that everybody understands from their own perspective how the whole concept of Shruti makes sense in their own way. And so I'm going to ask some questions to Dr. Sure. Vidyadhar Oak ji. And also we are joined with us Vidwan Dr. Srikant Nagendra Shastri ji, who is going to ask the question about the relevance of 22 Shrutis from the perspective of Karnataka music, Karnataka classical music. So we both are going to actually interview Dr. Oak, and he means
okay,
but I'm pretty sure that he's already with all his study and all his research and all his depth in this subject. So my first question to Dr. Oak sahab is, we have been hearing about Shrutis and a lot of confusion about the Shrutis, and I think this session is all the more important after what we saw this kind of confusion very recently. So my question to him is, how do you from the perspective of a normal layman, from noise all the way to Shruti, how do you describe this particular path, basically? That is something that will be great to know.
What is a Shruti is a question which is answered by different people in different ways. So firstly, before going to the 22 Shruti harmonium, we must try to appreciate what is the meaning of Shruti. And as I said, normally we hear so many sounds around us. these sounds to Shruti. How do we actually go there? Very simple. Whatever we hear in the nature, right now what you are hearing is actually not gongaat, or not, we can call them as dhwani. Dhwani means any sound. And a mixture of sounds can be, you said, what is the word you used? Noise. So a mixture of different kinds of sounds can be noise. But forget noise, I think we'll come down and we'll say dhwani. Dhwani is any sound which you hear. Very simple, dhwani. Now this is a sound. This is a sound. This is a sound. Are you hearing this? These are all sounds, and you can make any number of sounds. From sound, we have to graduate to a nada. Dhwani to a nada. What is the difference? What are those dhwanis which become a nada? When a dhwani has a musical quality, it becomes nada. When a dhwani has a musical quality, we can sing it. Suppose if there is a bell in a temple, tang. Now we can hear that sound and say, ah, tang. Another bell may be tang. We can sing it. Because there is a musical quality attached to it. So any sound with a musical quality attached to it becomes a nada. Now if we come on a string, now we come to music. If we come on a string, as you saw yesterday in a video, and all those people who have not seen video, I will explain in 1 minute, that when you begin from a lower shadjam to a higher shadjam, in between these, sa, sa, how many nadas are there? Innumerable. You can't measure them. You can divide this. This whole spectrum can be divided into 10 parts, 100 parts, 1000 parts, 10,000 parts, 1 lakh parts, 1 million parts, and all those would be nadas. So there are innumerable nadas from sa to sa, sharja to tara sharja. Now what is a shruti? Out of these, nature has selected 22 nadas for us to make music from. How many? 22 only. And they are selected not by Dr. Oak, not by Mr. Sambamurthy and other research workers. We are only trying to tell you what are those 22 shrutis selected out of innumerable nadas and why. And how knowingly or unknowingly, we are only using these 22 while making Indian music. So that is called as a shruti. For example, tambura nahi hai ikde, tambura hai, but theek hai. As I said yesterday, sa ga. See, suppose if we want to sing a gandhar, and then there is komal rishabh. When we sing, what are we singing? Ga re ga re re ga. Do you follow? I am singing something in between and here again. Can you appreciate this? Ga re. Just sing, no? Sing, no?
Ga re.
Go to go. Re ga ga re, or even from pa se pa re pa re, or sa to sa sa a a. Now in the piece which I am singing, how many notes are you able to identify? Here again. I am singing them continuously. There is no break. So I am using all those innumerable frequencies in between. Only two. One is a lower one and one is a higher one. In what he sang, we were able to identify only ga and ri. Nothing in between which was sung. This is the difference between nada and shruti. What you identify is a shruti. What you don't identify is a nada in between. Sa shruti. Sa shruti. Sa. What is in between? They are all called as nadas. They are not. This is the major problem in India. The difference between nada and shruti is not taught.
Sir, I have a question.
Sure, sure. Yeah. Please.
In Shastras, we have a shloka. So, chatus 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 chaiva.
Yeah.
Shajya madhyamba panchamaha.
Yeah.
Dvedve nishada gandharo. Tristri rishabhadevatav. So, how is your instrument is different from that concept?
It's not different. It is saying the same thing. I'll explain that.
Yeah.
I will be able to explain. But you have gone 4 or 5 questions ahead because we are much behind trying to first understand what is the difference between nada and shruti.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, why are shrutis 22? Stepwise, we'll go to them. And if I forget, you can ask again. So yeah. I'm not avoiding the question. No. So stepwise. Now, why are these? Did you understand the difference between nada and shruti? What, for example, if you want to sing this, re ma pa ni ni sa sa ni da pa da ma ga re a so a. Actually, I am saying, I have used these 5 shrutis connected by nadas. Have you understood the difference between nada and shruti? I hope you have understood. Now there are only 22 positions for us to make music from and connected by nadas. Now that point we will not take again.
Nada can we call it as gamakam?
Absolutely. Nada is used to create gamaka. See this now. Kodi. Yes. See this now. Actually, he's singing 2 shrutis. But yeah, he's connecting it with nadas. Can you see? Sing again. So we are again using. These are the shrutis, but he's connecting it continuously. And that is the beauty of Indian music. Only the connection system in Hindustani is different from Karnataka. Nadas with which we are connecting, the style is different, the dress is different. But basically the shruti remains the same. So you are absolutely right. When 2 shrutis are connected by gamakas, those gamakas are actually using nadas. And why are they using nadas? The definition of gamaka, gama means to go from one place to the other. So one place is and another place is. So if I want to go from re to ma, I'll say. You are absolutely right. So gamakas are played by a combination of shrutis with interconnecting nadas. Alapi is the same thing. When we say, it's going from Shadja to Nishad in a raga called Des or in Malakaus. Sagamadani. Sa. I'm not saying Sagamadani. Sagamadani. So you can see Shrutis complemented and connected by nadas, whether it is Karnataka classical, whether it is Indian classical. Okay. Coming back to why are Shrutis 22? Except for Sharja and Pancham, all the other 10 notes on a string start at a particular point and end at a particular point. Listen to this again. This is a eternal, international or universal truth on any string. Any string instrument. You take sitar, you take dilruba, you take violin, you take guitar, you take veena, you take sarangi, you take whatever. When you begin from one end, the next tara sharja is played exactly in the center of the string. And you will get sa, then komal re, then what we call ashuddha re, and all the 12 swara prakars in between. And for example, komal re. Sudarishavam. Yeah. So Sudarishavam or komal re on our side, the reason why they call it ashuddha, they means Karnataka call it ashuddha, and we call it as komal, is, I'll not explain it right now, but in komal rishabha, or Shuddha Rishabham in Karnataka, it starts on a string at one position and it ends on another position, giving a particular region for Shuddha Rishabham to be played. So we get two positions for one note. Then for Chatushruti Rishabham or Shuddha Rishabham, Apla Shuddha Rishabham, Shuddha Rishabham or Chatushruti Rishabham, again it starts at one place, ends at one place on a string. Again we got two positions. So we get two beginning and end for each of the 10 swaras. 10 multiplied by 2 is 20. And plus we have just one sharja and one pancham. So 20 plus 1, 21, and plus 1 becomes 22. So these are the 22 fixed positions with which we either make Karnataka Sangeet or we make Hindustani Sangeet or we make folk music or we make whatever music we want. Nature has only given these 22 positions and connecting nadas for us. So this is the meaning of Shrutis, and this is the meaning I explained to you why Shrutis are only 22 and not less and not more. See, not understanding this, many people have said, no, I have made 36 Shrutis. I have made 48 Shrutis. Shruti is not something which we can make in our kitchen as we want. Shruti is a, I told you, universal truth on the string. And please, for God's sake, can you believe, for example, that this Komal Rishab of Todi on Hindustani side, or this is Eka Shruti Rishabham or Shuddha Rishabham on the Karnataka slide, is played exactly at 94.92% length of the string.
So, but in
and
in
this a, is, 1 minute, yeah. Let me complete, yeah. Then you can. And this is true of any string instrument, any string, any sharjam, any place, any player, any time. Can you believe this? Therefore, I'm saying this is the eternal truth. And that is why please see my YouTube video where I have demonstrated 22 Shruti positions with percentages and with frequencies which we use in all the ragas. And if you have a veena at home, measure the, measure actually the vibrating distance, mark them, 22 Shrutis, and play them, you will make divine music because that is what God has given us.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Let me go to that, your four Shrutis, correct. Now just see, let us begin from Sharja and how 22 Shrutis are accommodated in this harmonium. The harmonium is normal harmonium. Can you see? The keyboard is absolutely normal. So just hear this now. Band kara. Chalu rao de. Chalu rao de. Tabla na. Shruti number one. Shruti number two. I am pulling a knob here, which you are not seeing, but let me do that again. Eka Shruti Rishabham. And now I'll go to Dvishruti Rishabham. Both are varieties of Suddha Rishabham. Both are varieties of Ati Komal Rishabh on our side. Hear this again. Next is Shuddha Rishabh on our side. Chatushruti Rishabh on our side. It has three Shruti as well as Chatushruti Rishabham. Firstly, three Shruti Rishabham. Going into Chatushruti Rishabham. Hear well. Sadharana Gandharam, lower and higher. Komal Gandhar, lower and higher. Shuddha Gandhar, Antar Gandharam. Shuddha Madhyamam, Shuddha Madhyam. Prati Madhyamam, Tivra Madhyam. Each has the lower and the higher. Why lower and higher? Because that is the way nature has arranged these notes on a string. We can't do anything. For Pancham, there is just one position. Suddha Daivatam, two positions again. Tishruti Daivatam, Suddha Daivatam. Komal Nishad. Kaishiki Nishadam. Lower and higher. Kakali Nishadam. Lower and higher. And Shajam. So this is the arrangement of 22 Shrutis on a string, which I showed first, and then I simply translated that into a harmonium, nothing else. So 22 Shruti harmonium is just a creation taken from the Veena. Or Shruti Veena and transplanted here. Now coming to his question of, we are always taught, Sharja has four Shrutis, Rishabha has three Shrutis, Gandhara has two Shrutis, and that is called as Sharja Gram. I think we were also discussing Rajendra the other day. He was asking, is this Sharja Gram, which was told by Bharata Muni, valid today? Let me tell you, it is not only very valid, we are singing the same thing. We'll see the demonstration now, okay? But before that, Chatushruti Re. See, in 28th chapter in Natya Shastra, the 25th shloka tells you that Shadja Chatushruti Neya, Rishabha Trishruti Smrutaha, Dvishruti Chapika Andaro, Madhyamaha Chatushruti, exactly what you said. People know this shloka very well. People do not know one shloka earlier, which was taught by Bharata Muni only. Same chapter. One earlier shloka says, when you take a string, when you begin from one side, you will get tisro dvecha chatastrascha. Listen to this. Chatastrastischa evacha dve chatastrascha Sharjakhe Grame Shruti Nidarshanam. Okay? So from one side, Tisro Dvecha Chatastrascha. So you will get the Sharja on the complete string. You can't show it in terms of the distance, because it is played from string to string. So the first note you will get on a string, see this, is Komal Rishabha starting. Shruti number one. Shruti number two, higher one, and then this is Shruti number three, Tisro. So on the third Shruti, there is Rishabha. Yeah. Tisro Dvecha Chatasracha. Then on the second Shruti, there is Gandhar. Then on the fourth Shruti from there is Madhyam. I'm not pulling these knobs, but you can see and pull exactly three knobs, two knobs, and go ahead, okay? So three. So three, two, four, four, three. Look here. Two, Nagendra, and four. So from the Kaishiki Nishad lower, the Shadja, which can be shown on a string for the first time, is a Tara Shadja coming on the fourth Shruti. You follow? So it is not that Shadja has four Shrutis. Shadja is on the fourth Shruti, is the meaning of Shadja Chatushruti Rinaya. It is not that Shadja has four Shrutis, because Madhyam and Panchama are also of four Shrutis. It doesn't mean we have four Madhyams and four Panchams. It cannot be that way. Unfortunately, not having understood the basic meaning and how these Shrutis appear on the string, many people tend to feel that there are four Madhyams and four Panchams. So how can this Pancham have four varieties? No, no, no. Pancham has four Shrutis, means from Suddha Madhyamam, it comes on the fourth Shruti. So that is the meaning of, and then we know char teen don, four, four, three, two, four, four. But before that, Bharata Muni has said, Tisro dvecha chatastrasya, from one end, chatastrasthisya evacha dve chatastrasya, shadjakhe grame shruti nidarshanam. So this became our shadjagram, and let us play it and see if we are using it today. The notes which came are actually using this today?
We are using Karharapriya.
Yes, absolutely. We are using is Karharapriya, Karharapriya, and in any raga which is coming out of Karharapriya. Abhogi. Or Kharar Priya, sing. Karnataka classical, but you will see we are using the same note. In Hindustani, for example, we will say but in Karnataka they will use the same note with a different style. Just sing. Whether it is our Kafi or Kharharapriya, we are using the same notes. And which are the same notes? These are the notes prescribed by Bharata Muni in Natya Shastra 2000 years ago. Let us take another thought, Natya. Huh. Chalanata. Yeah. Now, see the
this,
notes. Sorry.
This has Shatshruti Rishabham. Just explain that concept.
Yes. See, on the Karnataka side, on the Hindustani side, we have 12 swaras. On the Karnataka side, they have 12 swaras only, but they have 16 names.
Swarasthanas.
16 names. Now, what is the necessity of 16 names? See, if we take a raga, I'll just explain to the Hindustani audience first and then go to the Karnataka side because the terminology is slightly different. See this. If we take a raga like jog, then we will, the swaras there would be. So will you sa ga ga ma pa. So you will get two gandhars over here. So we will, in Hindustani said, sa ga ga sa, sa ga ma pa ma ga ga sa, sa ga ga ma pa ni pa ma ga ga sa. So we use two gandhars in such a raga. Karnataka, they are much more perfect in their principles. No raga can have two gandhars. So if there are two gandhars, they will use the first gandhar and call it as Rishabha. So rather than sa ga ga ma pa pa ma ga ga sa, Karnataka side will be sung pa ma ga ri. It is gandhar only, but it is called as Rishabha because it comes after Shadjam. Anything which is coming after Shadjam cannot be straight away called as Gandhar, and rightly so. Similarly, in a raga, ma pa ni ni sa, say in our mallar, we use this. Ma re re pa, ma pa ni ni. We use both the nishad and call it as ni and ni. On the Karnataka side, this will not be tolerated. They call it as ma pa da ni. It is the same note called as Daivatam, and that is called as Shatshruti Daivatam. Why Shatshruti? Because after Pancham, there are two Shrutis here, three and four here, five and six here.
Exactly.
Correct? That's why it is used. Right? So whenever you are using two Gandhars, the first one is known as Rishabha. Whenever you are using two Rishabhas, which does not happen in Hindustani at all. Hindustani, there is no raga where we use Komal Gandhar and Shuddha Rishabh, Komal Rishabh and Shuddha Rishabh. But whereas in Karnataka style, they have two Rishabhas. Take the first Thata, Kanakangi. Hindustani will call it as sa re re ma pa dha dha sa dha dha pa, two dhas, ma re re, two re's, sa. Karnataka slide, sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga.
Re 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 ne ne no ne ri ten re 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 mo re
point is, the same notes again are getting used in Carnatic style as well. So whenever there are two Rishabhas, one name will be added. Whenever there are two Gandhars, one name will be added. Whenever there are two Daivats, one name will be added. And whenever there are two Nishads, one name will be added. That is why 12 Swaras get 16 names. And out of these 16 names, or out of the 12 Swaras, Hindustani side, we only believe there are 10 Thattas, which is absolutely not true. And some point of time, Hindustani Sangeet will have to graduate to the Karnatak original system of 72 Melakarta Thattas. And how are these 72 Melakarta Thattas possible to demonstrate very quickly on 22 Shruti Harmonium? First is Kanakambari. You only say correct if the notes are correct. So people will know that what I am playing is correct. Then second Karnatak Melakarta Thatta, Ratnangi. Correct? Ganamurthi, Melakarta Thatta number 3. Melakarta Thatta number 4, Vanaspati. You want to sing something in this? No. So like this, all the 72 Thattas are ready for your disposal with perfect samvad. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. In 22 Shruti Harmonium, you get every possible note with a pancham or a madhyam, pancham or a gandhara available at your disposal, because these are three natural consonances or samvad available, made available by Tanpura.
Doctor, sorry. That actually brings me to a general question that normal lot of Indian classical music musicians would have, that sometimes in peculiar ragas like Darbari or other ragas, they use jala, what they call it, Uttarta Gandhar.
Yes.
Kiwa chadha.
Right.
Hey. So how do you describe that? And number one, that is question number one. And question number two is, there are few people who say that there are certain nadas, we may not call it shrutis from the definition that we just called. There are certain nadas which are musically correct, and they are also employed in the presentation of raga. So how do you look at those nadas from the perspective of 22 Shruti?
Wonderful question. People say, why 22 Shruti? We are using, we were taught something different and we will use them. You are free to use whatever you want. There is no compulsion. But the Shastra prescribes that if you use a particular nada, you should be using its madhyam and pancham. And outside these 22, the first one, if you select which is outside these 22, that itself is wrong. And the madhyam and pancham which you will select out of that again will be further wrong. So in fact, when we begin on a shruti which is completely outside this, you will see that getting a perfect madhyam and pancham consonant with this shadja will be impossible. And that is why, see, our ancient people, Bharatamuni or even people before that, they were quite well educated in music, and therefore they have restricted this to 20. Nadas are innumerable, but they restricted our saptak and our music to 22 positions. Why? Because God has described that Atsuddha Rishabham has only a beginning and an end where it can be differentiated.
So can we say that the nadas that musically sound pleasant in a particular melody or a raga may not, it can be accommodated as a nada, but we may not call it by the definition of shruti a shruti?
Absolutely. Shruti is that position on a string where the swara changes. That is why we are able to identify it. When the change happens, if there is no change, we will not be able to identify. That is why Matanga said, Grahanendriya Grahyatvad Dhvanireva Shrutir Bhavet. What is Grahanendriya? Grahanendriya is human ear. And what is Grahyatvad? Grahyatvad means to understand and appreciate. What is there to understand and appreciate? From a string, on a string, when you begin from one side, sa, you will reach a place where you get Sudarshan. So these are the positions of 12 swaras, ending and beginning, ending and beginning, ending and beginning. We are able to grahyatvad, grahanendriya, shravanendriya, grahyatvad. We are able to do that. And therefore, the classical definition is shruti. So out of these shrutis, those shrutis we select again for a raga become the swaras. Say Malakams, for example, Madhyamge. मध्यमन कर सजेस्ट हो सो वी हैव सिलेक्टेड फॉर मालकम्स सा ग म ध नी दीस फाइव श्रुतिज आउट ऑफ 22 एंड देन दे बिकम स्वराज ऑफ ए राग. So we have seen the transition from nada, from dhvani to nada, nada to shruti, and shruti to swara. So the process is absolutely complete. Coming to your question of darbari. In darbari, we use all the lower shrutis. These are the shrutis, and which shrutis, howsoever perfect they are, you cannot create Indian music unless you fill it with nadas. Ma pa ni ga ma re sa re re habag low re sa re ga ma re. Sarega ma ma pa ma pa da. This we call as andolan. So it is pancham and suddha daivatam. Ma pa da. So I am going from ma pada ni pa ma pada ni sa dhane sa re trishruti rishamam, not chatushruti rishamam, because it is lower and the raga itself is lower. Dhane sa re 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 ni sa re re ga ma re sa ni sa re da. So these connections of shrutis create a raga, and the gamakams create a raga. If you only play this, no raga will be created. Yeah.
So the next question obviously would be, yeah, how do you select a lower shruti or a higher shruti in respect, I mean, in from the perspective of the raga is being played?
Yeah.
And how do you decide in that raga whether the lower shruti of that swar or the higher shruti of that swar is to be
wonderful
selected?
See, this is actually, this work has been done by our ancestors. For example, when you want, let us take this, there is no time to explain all this, but we'll just take example of one note. Trishruti Rishabham, Chatushruti Rishabham, because there is no time. See this, Rajendra. This is Trishruti Rishabham, lower Rishabham. The one we use in Darbari. Sare re. The one we use in Abhogi. Sare re. The one we use in Gorakkalyan. Sare ma re re. Why will you use this? Because this Trishruti Rishabham is completely samvadi or consonant with Suddha Madhyamam. See this. And see the samvad. If we play this on a standard harmonium, see how it will sound. And if I play them together, whereas here, because of the shrutiness and because these swaras are given by nature, there is a complete consonance. Look at this. So sare, so you will see this Rishabha, lower Rishabha, always in combination with Suddha Madhyamam. Let us take Bageshri. Sagama, see how beautifully you get this samvad. Whereas in a normal harmonium it will be unplayable, unsingable. Here Nidhama Padama Gare Magare Nidhasa. So this has been done by our ancestors. Now this is lore. Let us take Yaman, common example. These 22 Shruti system, our ancestors have ensured that in any raga you will only get consonant notes. See how Yaman, if I want to tune this harmonium for Yaman, the notes only are. But I want to perfectly tune them. So firstly, Sagapa. Now, I want to take Re. This is Trishruti Re or lower Re. And Pancham. There is no samvad. I have to increase three shruti to chatushruti and see the difference. Do you see the difference? See this. Now I got my chatushruti rishabham. Now see how beautifully it makes tivra madhyam or prati madhyamam. It's antargandharam. See this. Aha. Now re is higher, so dhaivat also will have to be higher. See this. Now sagapa becomes a natural triad. Remadha becomes a natural triad. Sagapa. And pani re. So sagapa, remadha, pani re, all become sagapa. Sagapa, sagapa, sagapa. And then what happens? Look at this magic.
Basically, all swaras are played, but you cannot really make it out that. That's what the demonstration is. Because they're in perfect consonant, although you're playing all the notes, they're sounding like one note, basically.
You will not believe, but I'm playing every note. So this is what happens when you have 22 shrutis. Here, what will happen, you know. I won't even play. Okay. That's okay.
Okay. So I think this subject is such that, you know, you can just go on talking and we
I know. Need but to did have you, 1 minute, did you get some idea about what a Shruti is and what a 22 Shruti harmonium is? Yes. And did you appreciate that we can take 2,000 more shrutis of what we want, but they will not be as perfect as nature has made for us on a string. Okay? Any question anybody has? We'll take just a couple of questions maybe.
Running out of time.
First class.
So maybe if anybody has any questions, they can
contact me later.
Dr. Vidyadharuk directly. And thanks again for joining us here. Thank you to Shastriji and to Dr. Vidyadhar Oak. And thanks to you all for being such a patient and such a involved audience. Thanks a lot from all of us and from the... Thanks a lot.
Right from Bharata's Natya Shastra, Matanga Munis, Brihadeshi, Sangeeta Sara or Sampradaya Pradarshini up to the recent most dissertation topic of any university, a constant effort has been made to understand Ahata and Anahata Nada, and the ultimate goal of any student or musician is to understand or to recognize Anahata Nada. In that aspect, understanding of 22 Shrutis become most important, or it plays vital role in attaining this stage, and the group of these three musicians have put in a tremendous effort to make us understand all these 22 Shrutis, or the differences, or from the frequency perspective as well as from the experimentation perspective. Thanks to all these musicians yet another time from all of you with a round of applause for making us understand. Request Shrikantham Nagendra Shastriji to kindly accept the memento on behalf of the foundation. Rajendra Katoti sir is presenting the memento. Thanks to Vidyadhar sir also. You will get whole day wherein you will talk right from Kanakangi up to Rasika Priya.